got involved with a meeting with the AOPA because of some issues with the small unmanned aerial systems that the federal government is going to be integrating into the national airspace. And as part of that, we're part of that meeting and activity that's going on with that. Part of that, AOPA and AMA were on that committee meeting. And developed some relationships and friendships, and the AOPA president was at one of our events in Wichita and saw us flying indoor stuff and said, wow, this is really cool. We'd like to have you as part of the expo. We said, that'd be great. We'll see what we can work out. So we had a couple of meetings and came down here. They got us the hangar to fly in, and so we're out showing what model airplanes are all about. Obviously, we can get started with youth and younger kids from 2, 3, 4-year-olds. We have programs for them. And as you migrate up into the radio control, we have as much as you want to get involved in it. Really, just like general aviation. You can be just a sport flyer and enjoying the day and going out and flying, or you can get really involved in commercial or whatever. And we basically have that with modeling. And many of our flyers come back to us after maybe their aviation career is over, they lost their medical or whatever, they come back to modeling because it's a way for them to continue to enjoy aviation. And we support them with that. The nice thing about it is you can fly so many different types. If you flew jets, military jets, buy an F-4 Phantom and go have fun. A transport aircraft, a J-3 Cub, all those things are available to you. So, you know, we're kind of able to let people continue their modeling experience or their aircraft experience. And even with aircraft that maybe somebody flew a P-51 but they never got their hands on an F-16, well, now you can do that. So it allows you to do a lot of things that you otherwise couldn't do.
If you own a Cirrus today or if you are considering the purchase of a new or used aircraft, consider this. Avadyne, in conjunction with the country's leading Cirrus sales and maintenance facilities, has launched the G3R9 program that combines the purchase of a late model, low-time Cirrus aircraft and the addition of the Avadyne Integra Release 9 avionics suite for much less than you may have thought, and certainly much less than purchasing a brand new aircraft. G3R9, combining the best airframe, best engine, and best avionics for the best value.
Light sport aircraft have been promoted as an entry level into aviation, but if you go around and talk to a lot of, especially the Korea and World War II era pilots of full-size aircraft, they tell you they got their start in model airplanes, gluing sticks together. Is this the real entry level?
Well, it really is, and I think what happened, if you look at those era people, their heroes were different. They were the Lindberghs of the day. And aviation and technology was just in the golden era of booming. You know, we had all these aviation base stuff was just starting, even though it was just basic exploration, it was all starting. And so you had this real interest in anything aviation oriented. The wars kind of helped with that too. People looked at the war pilots and the aces as kind of idols. And so that's really what most people could say, well, I want to do that, but I don't have the funds or the availability to do that, but I can do it through model aircraft. And that's been our great grab for people for a long time.
Obviously, for a young kid getting interested in aviation, or let's say a young kid whose parents identify an opportunity to get him involved in something positive in his life, getting him interested in aviation, what does it cost? What's the entry level to get into these indoor electrics, which look way, way simpler and easier to get into than the old Cox 49 glow plugs that I remember?
The electric models, we have models that start in the $30 to $40 range, complete with radio systems. Most of the models we're flying here today are maybe $100 to $125 and up. They're very simple in that they're complete, they're ready to fly out of the box. So there's not a lot of aggravation of trying to put something together. The really cool thing, they're electric. So you're not dealing with finicky motors and trying to figure all that out. Today you just plug in a battery and go fly, and it really makes it nice. It's clean, it's quiet. Moms really like both of those things. You know, we can fly in parks and places that are maybe urbanized, but we don't want noise there. So they may be walking dogs or playing soccer, and we can fly model airplanes on the other end. We're not bothering anybody. So it's really a good activity. Also, our education department, we have some programs for teachers where we help them to teach science, physics, and math through aviation. And we have some programs that AMA's developed with the Alcoa company that we utilize in schools. And that's available for teachers too. So we see the interest in math, science, technology. That's where our aviation engineers and designers come from. And if we can help that era for those kids to be interested in college or interested in a technical aviation-oriented career, that's where we're pointing them. And that fits in just very, very nicely with AOPA and the military and commercial interests.
Cirrus Designs Vision SJ50 single engine personal jet offers exceptional fuel efficiency, flexible seating for up to 7, advanced avionics, and all the Cirrus safety features you expect, including the Cirrus airframe parachute system. With its V-tail design, the Cirrus Vision is technologically advanced, yet engineered to be simple to fly, to allow owner pilots more lifestyle pursuits than any other personal aircraft. Learn more about the Vision SJ50 at cirrusdesign.com.
Now there's another whole side to this sport, and that's the competition side. I have no clue how extensive that is or what it costs or who's in it or where they go or what they do. Tell us a little bit about it.
Well, competition's kind of my background. I've been flying competition since 1971, and I was lucky enough to be the USA team manager for 4 world championships. I went to Japan and Poland and Austria, and we had a really good time. Was able to win a world championships a couple of times. So it's more extensive than most people realize. We actually have a complete program on competition of all different types of models, from racing, scale, aerobatics, indoor, all kinds of different competitions. And we send teams from all over the country around the world for these competitions. So we support that. And here again, it's a goal that people can look at and try to achieve. And one of our pilots, or one of our demo pilots here today, is Jason Shulman. And he's been on the team with me for 4 of the times that I was team manager. And he's currently our number sixth in the world rated pilot, so we're lucky to have him here today.
Now, if somebody wants to find out more about this magazine, website, how?
We have magazines, we have actually 2 websites. The easiest way to remember is modelaircraft.org. Go to that website. We have links to several different sites. We can give you information on how to become a member. We can also give you information on finding a local club that's in your area. And most of the clubs have programs where they would be more than happy to take you out and get you a test flight on a model to see if it's something you want to do. And I think that's a great way to let people see what we have and how to get involved. Modeling is a very social aspect event. You know, you develop friends for a lifetime. We find that when we talk to some of these club members, you know, some of these guys have been flying together for 30 years, and they get together on Tuesday afternoon for a cup of coffee and enjoy airplanes, and that's what we want.